Welcome to Learn Fusion 360 for Laser Cutting. This series is sponsored by SendCut Send, an online laser and CNC cutting service that offers free two-day shipping, a variety of materials to choose from, and instant quotes. We'll use this example phone stand throughout this series, which you can download from the link below. Once you finalize your design, we'll need to lay all our parts flat on the same planar surface. This is because laser cutters only work on the X and Y axes. In other words, they cut in only two dimensions. The workflows covered in this lesson are for Fusion 360 models created with the standard solid and surface modeling tools. If you use Fusion 360's sheet metal tools, you'll want to check out our other lesson on unfolding sheet metal designs. In Fusion 360, there are three main ways to lay non-sheet metal parts on a planar surface. The first and easiest method is to use the arrange feature. The second approach is to use a Fusion 360 add-in such as Mapboards Pro. And the third and most time-consuming is to manually layer components flat using Fusion 360 joints to reposition each part. Let's take a look at using the arrange feature. It's important to note that the arrange feature is not available to those on Fusion 360's free personal use license. Hobbyists on the personal use license can skip ahead and use the other two methods. To use arrange, we first need to head to Fusion 360's manufacture workspace. Select the workspace's dropdown, followed by manufacture. Once here, we need to select create manufacturing model. A manufacturing model allows you to create a model for setup and editing in the manufacture workspace without affecting the original model in the design workspace. Notice how our manufacturing model is now active in the Fusion 360 browser. We'll need to edit the model to access the arrange feature. Right-click on the manufacturing model and select Edit Manufacturing Model. This places us in a contextual edit environment. Remember that any changes we make here will only affect this manufacturing setup and will not affect the original design file. Under the Modify dropdown, you will now see the arrange feature. Note that this is only available in the manufacture workspace while editing a manufacturing model. Arrange is not available in the design workspace or any other workspaces. Once active, we'll want to select each component that we would like to lay flat. You can simply omit any parts of your design that will not be laser cut. We then need to define a plane, sketch, or face that our selected components will lay on. It's recommended to create a simple sketch with the bounding box or size that you would like to stay within. However, we can also use the bottom origin plane. Be sure to turn on your origin folder in the browser if it is not already visible. Planes do not have a length and width, so we'll need to type one out in the dialog. Let's try 200 by 200 millimeters. Notice how the parts automatically lay flat on the selected plane. We can also define the frame width, or how much space is between the edge of our part and the edge of our frame. Item separation will allow you to define the amount of space between each object. For example, I'll change this to 1 millimeter. Notice how the parts are now closer together. Lastly, if you need to change the direction of any objects, you can toggle the flip button in the dialog or select the arrow in the canvas. Note that you can also flip the entire sheet in the dialog. This will flip all selected objects at the same time. Once you're happy with the layout, simply click OK to confirm. This example part has only two components or parts, but as you can imagine, this can save significant time with multi-part designs. You'll want to select Finish Edit once your parts are laid flat and you're done altering the manufacturing model. If I now flip back to the design workspace, you'll notice the changes did not affect the original model. However, one great benefit is that most updates we make in the design workspace will be synced with the manufacture workspace. This makes it easy to manage design updates without having to rework your arrange parts each time. The second method to lay parts flat, which is to use a Fusion 360 add-in, is a great alternative to using the arrange feature, particularly for those on the free personal use license who cannot access the arrange feature. We won't be looking at any add-ins in this video. I recommend checking out the lesson which covers using the Mapboards Pro add-in, which is a great alternative to the arrange feature. To summarize, we looked at using the arrange feature to lay parts flat for laser cutting. If you do not have access to the arrange feature, you can utilize one of the third-party add-ins to access similar workflows. In the next lesson, we'll take a look at the third method, which is to use Fusion 360 joints to reposition components.